In this video, we're going to run Calibre LVS from LEdit. We're going to assume that you've seen the DRC video that corresponds to this one already. That one includes a certain amount of configuration information that is not going to be duplicated here. In LEdit, you'll want to ensure that your layout is open. And in SEdit, you want to have the corresponding schematic open. Then from the Calibre toolbar, click LVS. First dialog box you'll see by default is this one. A run set's a configuration file, and we don't have one yet for Calibre Interactive. We'll discuss saving one later. So we'll cancel this. In the Rules tab, we will find our rule file. Some people will load it at this point. That runs the rule file compiler immediately and would trap any compilation errors up front. If you don't do that now, the compiler would get run later. Simply a matter of preference. And we'll set our run directory. On the Inputs tab, everything's going to be largely OK by default. You can always change the automatically populated file names in the GUI if you wish. On this tab, we'll want to make sure that Export from Layout Viewer is enabled. On the Netlist tab, select Export from Schematic Viewer. That causes SEdit to write this SPICE netlist at runtime, and that's what is used in Calibre LVS comparison. For larger designs, you will want to visit the H-Cells tab and configure the H-cell list. An H-cell list is a correspondence list for cell names in the layout and the source. For smaller designs, you may not have an H-cell list, but for larger designs, you probably will. So you might want to remember that for reference. On the outputs pane, pretty much everything here is going to be fine by default. These two options underneath SVDB database, you want to make sure that those are enabled. That's your LVS debugging environment. Under Setup, you can enable LVS options and go to the Shorts tab, and we'll run Short Isolation. And when you run that, it's usually a good idea to select Output Shorts by Layer. Now we have enough information to run the job. The results will open in Calibre RVE. One of the first things that you should do is visit the reports items over here in the navigator. You should read through the reports and be sure you understand what's in them. They contain quite a bit of useful information for debugging. The results database information is loaded over here. We can see, I'll expand this a bit so we can see more of it. In the extraction results tab, this is the results from the circuit extractor module. You can expand this tree and you can see the circuit extractor found a short. This is a text short. Down here are the details. The circuit extractor assigned a net ID of 5 to a net. It found two labels on it. One is called A, one is called Out. These are the coordinates of the labels, and in this case they were on metal 2. And the circuit extractor chose net name A as the name of the net. So now we'll use this to probe the layout. You can click these hyperlinks in the Details pane, and we'll click the 5, which is the node that the circuit extractor assigned. over here in RVE, the layout and source net lists open along with the native schematic viewer in RVE, and this blue net is net 5 in layout and source net list. Over here in L-Edit, you can see that this is net 5 that got highlighted, and this is the one with a short. Then we can look at these coordinates. This is the coordinates of label A. There you can see it. These are the coordinates of label out. So you can see that. And if we were to zoom out a little bit, you can see that in context a bit better. In RVE, when you want to clear highlights, you click the eraser icon. And you'll notice that the highlights are cleared here as well as down here in the native schematic viewer in RVE. Next, we can come to the Layout Shorts tab. This contains essentially the same information as the Circuit Extraction Results tab for this short. The Circuit Extraction Results tab can have a lot more things in it than shorts. You know, it can have opens and bad devices and other things in it. Layout Shorts is just simply the shorts that were found during circuit extraction. In this case, we can double-click this result, and it highlights this metal 2 polygon. And so that's being identified as likely cause of this short. And if you clear highlights, this polygon here is the problematic one, at least it's presumed to be. In the Comparison Results tab, we'll cancel these for now to expand this view a little bit. You can, again, expand this tree. This is the LVS comparison, layout versus source. And this lists all the discrepancies. And in this case, we have an incorrect net discrepancy. And here's discrepancy 1, and we can click it. Expand this to see it. This is typical of a short circuit in an LVS report. You can see over here on the source side, there are two nets that are being matched to one net in the layout. So something bridged these two nets and caused them to be recognized as one net in the layout. And so, that's typical of what a short looks like in a comparison results report. At this point, if you fix the layout and you wanted to run LVS again to check your fix, you can come back to Calibre Interactive and run LVS and go through the job. Probably would also want to run DRC after modifying the layout as well. Up here in the transcript menu, you can save the transcript using these items. The transcript window, again, is over here. And if the configuration of the GUI is good and you want to save it for the future, you can come to File and Save Run Set, and you can save the configuration of the GUI into a run set file that you can load at the beginning of a later session.